I saw you just met my two dogs. So, as Maro would do, legendary clap. Welcome home. I'm Jules Gounon and welcome to Andorra. Let's go straight into the living room with the beautiful view of Andorra and on my teammate from Australia. He came all the way here. We raced together in Asian Le Mans and I always love to have guests. So that's actually the mountain we're gonna hike afterwards. Hopefully there will be a bit more sunshine. Nice terrace in the morning, you can take your coffee, look at the view. So after looking at the main asset of that apartment, which is the view, you know, in the morning you wake up from the bedroom, you see that beautiful view from the living room. It's just amazing. I discovered that therapy called color déco therapy from Marianne Sauzet, that after a long quiz about yourself, find the color that suits you the most. And actually, when now we have decorated with the colors and so on, I really feel relaxed, which is important for me after a long race weekend. Coming into the kitchen, a part that I really enjoy being at is when I'm cooking and I'm looking at that view, even if I'm a bad cooker and put vegetables everywhere. And I think you're gonna enjoy the other part of the flat too. It's gonna be very interesting, but first, I think we should go to the garage, take the car, go in the mountains and see how beautiful Andorra is.
Gilles, can we continue?
Sorry, actually my girlfriend is leading the race, so I actually need to watch a bit.
But without a joke, I don't know where are my shoes.
This car is an E63S, one of my favorite cars when I was a child. The car has the chance to be very fast, a lot of horsepower, a lot of fun, and then in the same time as we are driving now, very comfortable, very easy. That's the two sides of the AMG that I really love.
Look at that!
Beautiful nature, the snow, we are going to the snow. I love this place.
In 21, I had three race weekend without racing before the 24 Spa, and I trained flat out in this environment, in high altitude, and I think I never felt so good in my life. The power you get by training in low oxygen, high altitude, your blood became like when you go back to sea level, you're flying. It's amazing. You know, for me, hiking is a bit like life. You go up and up, it's hard. Sometimes you don't see the summit. You doubt yourself, am I gonna make it? And time to time, you sit down, look back, look what you have accomplished, how much you have went up, and then you still look up and find some more motivation to go reach the summit. And hopefully, when you never give up, you will finally make out to the summit. And now I think a pretty interesting topic for AMG fans, my favorite trophies, at least I could put a few there. This one on the top left is the first Platz, Rennen 2, for my poor German, of GT Masters. Back in that time, I got very lucky to meet Ernst Vohr and Giovanni Ciccone and all the Callaway team that gave me my chance. They invited me for a test in Hockenheim, it was amazing. And they gave me my chance to, with my little sponsors, to prove we won the race. Without meeting those two guys and a few other guys there, I would not be in front of that camera. Second one, actually the latest one, Petit Le Mans winner in GTD Pro with my two good friends Mauro and Danny. Very emotional to finish the season like this because we won the 24 of Daytona at the beginning of the season. Won Petit Le Mans and became IMSA Endurance Champion, that trophy right there. Next one. Another big one for me and for the guys. We won the 24 Spa 2022 with Danny again and Raffaele Marcello, Lelo. For me, it's one of the toughest races in the world. It was 10 years AMG didn't win it, so it was very emotional for us. Next to it, 24 of Nürburgring third with Danny again and Mauro, same guys. That race was a bit painful, I have to say, because we felt we were pretty unlucky, which made us finish P3, but to finish P3 on such an iconic race is great. and it motivates us even more to go and grab and tick the bucket list. On the right side, the first Spa 24-hour win for me. You know, as a 22 years old boy, being on the podium with legends like Marcus and Christopher and other guys, actually Lelo and Edo Morta were P3 that year, so I didn't understand what happened, so very important one for me. On the right, second in the 24-hour Spa again, so that was this year with Lelo and Timur. Next to it, a win on home soil in Paul Ricard with IMG. This year actually with Lelo and Timur. So to win in France in Paul Ricard was always great, especially on one. Also back in the day with Jordan Pepper and Stephen Kane in the Bentley. That was a great emotion also. So that's why it's there. And on the right, the 2022 Fanatec GT World Champion with Danny and Lelo, also important ones. Now on our way to my simulator room and my office room, which is quite important for a racer. But on our way, some important picture for me. The first one, Mercedes-AMG GT3 sparking through Wippermann in the Nürburgring Nordschleife, one of the most iconic track. It's on my big bucket list to win with Danny and Mauro, hopefully in the next year. But this picture was just so lovely that I wanted to put it there. The livery was mega. And another very emotional picture for me. 2 years ago, Kenny put that project that his goal was to try to win Bathurst overall, which has never been made for an amateur driver. And we actually did it this year with Lukas Stolz, Kenny and I, which was our second victory in a row with this team and third in a row for me. So now we're coming to the simulator room, which I spend some time getting my ass kicked by the sim racer. This is not so fun, but I enjoy still to train before the race weekend, which is important for me. And a little bit of trophies. Let's say the most important one are the one we saw at the entry, but still some important one. 24th Nürburgring third, second overall in Le Castellet. And then all my helmets. We can start with my first helmet from go-kart. I started very late, I was 16. And when I started, I had a white helmet, which looked really bad. And I always told my dad, I want to have a painted helmet. And he said that I would deserve it only if I win a few races. So it was a great motivation to get one. So on my second year, I finally got one. Then I would go to a second very important helmet for me, the helmet of my granddad. That is an helmet from 1969. Imagine, look at the flexibility of the helmet. At that time, you better not chant, let's say. Another very important one, my 99 dad's helmet, actually with the sticker from Le Mans. In that pursuit, I did a revival helmet, which is exactly the same lid as my dad. The yellow is a bit more bright. This helmet was really important for me, same interior. And every time I race it and I saw my dad was getting emotional was something I love to try to make my dad proud. On every of my helmet, as you can see, I always have a panda. The story started from that little cutie. My first ever race in go-kart, we went to a very famous brand of restaurant in France, which is called Courte Paille. And when I arrived for food, the waiter told me, "You're a bit tall, but we have one panda left, so even if you're a bit too old, we're gonna give it to you." And you can see, I still have the etiquette from the restaurant, 2010, this one. And funny enough, every time in my career I had big breaks or very lucky escape or so on, there was a panda. When I had a big crash in Adac GT Master, lost the championship, I wake up in the hospital, and on top of the TV, one panda. I go to my first interview with Giuseppe Rizzi to do the first time the 24 of Le Mans. He invites me to restaurant, panda restaurant in the plate. Every time I have big moment in my life, there is a panda that appears for somewhere. So that's why I have always a panda. I have also a tattoo of panda behind my watch here. So now you know the story why I have a panda behind my helmet. Another part of this room, I would say my suits, because I have a few that I've been able to collect in the last few years. One I actually like is the one of my girlfriend. That is very important. And I would say also the Bathurst one, because this story people doesn't know. Obviously with Kenny, we had this suit that was the main suit of Kenny. Before the race, I had one suit made by Puma, and Carlo, one of my engineer from my HBA, took the suit in Germany. And her daughter decided to make a unicorn on my suit because she said it was bringing luck. And while I was going to take my last double stint to the end to try to win the race, I had the yellow suit and I said, you know, when a kid of 8 years old is very cute and tell you, this suit is gonna bring you a lot. I say, well, why not? I'm gonna take it. And the rest was just history. So thanks to that Unicode became the third time winner there. So that was it, trying to be quick, which is difficult because every trophy has an history. I could tell exactly what happened in that race, why we won, why we didn't win. And that's what I love about trophies. You always keep a memory and you remember the tears or the joy that the races bring.